Hello and welcome to the session in which we will discuss deferred annuity. Before you learn about deferred annuity, make sure you understand the present value of an ordinary annuity and a single payment and the future value of an ordinary annuity and the future value of a single payment. It's critical. Don't attempt deferred annuity unless you have the basics, because without understanding those two, you won't be able to understand the concept of deferred annuity. Now, this topic is covered usually in a finance course, but you could see it also on the CPA exam in a multiple choice, where you are being asked to find the present value of a deferred annuity. Whether you are an accounting student or a finance student or a CPA candidate for that matter, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition. I explain the material differently than your CPA review course. I can help you understand your CPA review course better. Your subscription is 1 month. You can try me. See if you like it. You like it, you keep it. You don't, you cancel. So your risk is limited to 1 month, but your potential gain is passing the exam. My resources cover many other accounting courses such as intermediate, governmental, tax, advanced, so on and so forth. My supplemental review courses are aligned with your actual review course, whether it's Beck or Roger, Wiley or Gleam. And I do have all the AICPA previously released questions, which is approximately 1,500 of them, with detailed solution. Please connect with me on social media if you haven't done so, and connect with me on LinkedIn and take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation. Like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So let's take a look at the deferred annuity and what does it mean. It means that the rent payments begins after a specified period in the future. So simply put, it looks something like this. If this is the time frame, this is 0, 1, 2, 3. So the payments don't, or the receipts don't start until year 4, year 5, year 6. So the first 3 years, you don't get anything or you don't pay anything. So this is what a deferred annuity is. So we have to compute the deferred annuity, whether it's the future value or the present value. The good thing about the future value, it's the same thing as the future value of a regular annuity. There's nothing to defer about. So if you are being asked to compute the future value of an amount that's starting in year 3, it goes from year 3, 4, 5, and 6. It doesn't really matter. The future value is the same computation. You don't have to make any adjustment. The present value of a deferred annuity would require you to take two-step process. The step one is to find the present value of the annuity at the future date. So basically, find the present value of the annuity. Then the second step, once you find the present value of that annuity at the future date, you find the present value you computed in step one as a single amount. Well, the best way to show you this is to actually show you an example, this two-step process. Okay, how much you will pay for an investment that will pay you 6 annual payments of $5,000 starting 5 years from now, earning 8%. So here's what you are being promised here. How much will you pay for this investment? But we're not going to pay you anything now. You're going to pay us the money, but you have to find out how much you should pay. And we're going to start paying you the money. We're going to start making the payment year 5, 5 years from now. So year 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And we're going to be giving you $5,000. Each X is $5,000. We're going to be giving you those 6 annual payments. Okay? And how much you're going to be earning? N equal to 6, 6 periods, and I equal to 8%. Well, the first thing we do using this two-step process is first find the present value of this annuity. Just simply treat it as an annuity. You are standing at year 4. Well, N equal to 6, I equal to 8. I'm going to go to the present value factor of my table. N equal to 6, so this is 6. I equal to 8, this is 8. And the present value factor is 4.6229. So simply put, I'm going to take my $5,000, find the present value of those, times 4.6229, and let me find the answer for this. So we get 5,000 times 4.6229, and that's equal to $23,114. So at year four, you are standing at year four with $23,114. Well, we don't care about year four because this is into the future. We want to know how much is the present value of this payment today. Well, I have to go back and discount this 3, 2, 1, 0. So I have to discount this one. I have to discount it as a single payment, because once I find the present value of the annuity, so the red part is the annuity, now it's a single payment problem. So I have to find the single payment value, 23,114. So here n equal to 4, I equal to 8%. And let me find, going to the present value of a single amount table, I'm going to have to find the factor, n equal to 4, I equal to 8%, and that's 0.735. So if I take this amount times 0.735, that's going to give me 16,989.15. So this is how much I will pay today, or how much this deferred annuity is worth today. If I want to earn 8%, and starting to receive the payment 5 years from now. Obviously, you can prove it to yourself if you're interested in that. So that's one way in computing the deferred annuity. There's another way that you can compute this deferred annuity, by computing the deferred annuity for 10 years, then subtracting 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Remember, the payments don't start until year 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what you do, another way to do this is another method, is to look at this annuity as a 10-year annuity, find the present value of a 10-year annuity, then subtract, then deduct 4 years from it. Well, what do I mean by this? Well, it means take the $5,000, first, assume it's a 10-year annuity, and I prefer the two-step, because the two-step, you can see what's going on, but here it's the same concept, just you have to be comfortable with what you are doing here. So basically, so we're assuming here is n equal to 10, I equal to 5, and the factor is 6.7101, and this is n equal to 10, I equal to 8. And let's see what's the answer for this. Take 5,000 times 6.7101. Well, what we're going to do, we're going to subtract before we do the computation, because there's no need to do the computation before we do the subtraction. We can do the computation to do the subtraction, but let's factor it out. Then we're going to subtract from this total factors. We're going to subtract this part here. We're going to subtract n equal to 4, I equal to 8%. So n equal to 4, I equal to 8, and that is 3.3121 minus 3.3121. So let's see. So we have a factor of 6.7101 minus 3.3121. And that's equal to 3.398. Now we'll take the 5,000 times 3.398, and that's going to give us 16,990. Let's see if we are close to the answer. Well, that's at 16,990. At the end of this recording, I'm going to remind you, whether you are an accounting student, a finance student, or a CPA candidate, to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition. Your CPA exam is worth it. Invest in yourself. Invest in your career. Study hard. Good luck. And of course, stay safe.